we just began with control systems, and in control systems we started with block diagram representation. And today in this lecture we shall see the rules for block diagram reduction. So let us see some of the rules and how these rules will actually help us to reduce and simplify the block diagram. So the first rule is, if two blocks are connected in series or in cascade. So let us consider two blocks with G1 and G2, the transfer functions, the input being R of S, and let the intermediate be X of S and the output be C of S. So therefore, if two blocks are connected in series, what happens? Now we know that X of S is nothing but equal to R of S into G1. So it's going to be R of S into G1, whereas the output C of S will be equal to X of S into G2. But what is X of S? It is equal to R of S into G1. So therefore, C of S is nothing but R of S into G1 into G2. So what happens if two blocks or more blocks are connected in series or cascade? We just multiply the individual transfer functions. If two blocks are connected in parallel, so let us assume that I have two blocks with transfer functions G1 and G2, and let the input be R of S. So here I have R of S, and here also I have R of S. So now these two blocks are in parallel, and let us assume that these two are being either added or subtracted, and the output is C of S. Alright, so now what is the output coming here? The output here is R of S into G1, and here it is R of S into G2. So whether I have an addition sign or a subtraction sign, if it is plus, then these two get added. If it is minus, then these two would be subtracted. So therefore, the output C of S would be R of S G1 plus minus R of S G2. Right? So depending on whether you have addition or subtraction. Can you take R of S common? Yes, of course. So it's going to be G1 plus minus G2. Right? So if these two are added, then I have G1 plus G2. If I'm subtracting, then I have G1 minus G2. Or if I have, say, minus plus, I would have minus G1 plus G2 and so on. So that just depends on whether you have a plus sign or a minus sign. So in general, if I write plus minus, I can write plus minus here also. So it would be plus minus G1 plus minus G2. Okay, or just to make it very simple, if I just include a plus minus sign here, then it would be G1 plus or minus G2. To move takeoff point behind a block. So what do we mean by this? So let's assume that I have R of S, then I have a block with function G of S, and then I have a takeoff point C of S. Alright, and then I have another output C of S. So now I have C of S equals R of S into G of S. So this is a takeoff point here, wherein I'm actually getting the output, which is R of S into G of S. So now the question is, if I move the takeoff point behind the block. So if I move the takeoff point behind the block, what will I get? So I have R of S, then I have G of S. So here, of course, I would get C of S equals R of S into G of S. So this is fine. But if I move the takeoff point behind, essentially what would happen? I would get C of S equal to R of S alone, right? Because there is absence of G of S. But at the output, what do I need? I need R of S into G of S. So therefore, I need to include a block with function, transfer function G of S. So what happens if I move the takeoff point behind the block? I need to include the transfer function in the later section here, wherein I include G of S in this path so that I get C of S equals R of S into G of S. So the next rule, to move takeoff point after a block. So in the previous section we had seen that we had to move the takeoff point before a block, so now it is after a block. So now here I have R of S and then I have G of S. I get the output C of S and I have the takeoff point here. I get R of S itself. So now the question is, I have to move this takeoff point after the block. So this point has to be moved after the block. So when I move this after the block, definitely I would get R of S multiplied with G of S here. So if I have R of S, I have G of S. So this is the straight path wherein C of S equals R of S, G of S. But what have I done? I've shifted the takeoff point after the block. So I have the takeoff point here. And since I have a takeoff point here, I would get C of S equals, I would get the output which is equal to R of S into G of S. But what do I need? I need only R of S. So therefore, I need to include a block with transfer function 1 by G of S such that the output will be R of S into G of S divided by G of S, which will give me R of S itself. So therefore, if I move the takeoff point after the block, I need to include a block with the transfer function, which is nothing but the reciprocal of the transfer function considered here in the block. So keep that in mind. So it's going to be 1 by G of S. Fifth one, to remove a block from output of a summer. So let us consider R of S and then I have a summer. So it's going to be plus X of S. So here what do I get? I get R of S plus X of S. And then I have G of S. So therefore the output C of S is this term multiplied with G of S, isn't it? So it's going to be R of S into G of S plus X of S into G of S. So this is what I have here. So here what has to be done? I'm actually removing a block from the output of a summer. So when I need to remove a block from the output of a summer, that means I'm including this block at the input. So let's see what happens. So I have R of S and then I have the block because I'm removing this block from the output, and then of course I have the summer. What should be the output? Now let us assume that this input is X of S. Now here I get R of S into G of S. So here I'm getting R of S into G of S, but here I'm getting X of S. So therefore the output C of S would be R of S, G of S plus X of S. But what do I need? We need X of S into G of S. So therefore we have to include the block here in this part, G of S. So that I get G of S into X of S, which gets added to the summer. So thereby we get C of S equals R of S, G of S plus X of S into G of S. Alright, so these are some of the fundamental rules for block diagram reduction. So now let us take an example and let us see how we can reduce the block diagram. So we'll take one example here and then in the next two lecture sessions we shall solve a few more examples wherein we try to reduce the block diagram using these rules which we have defined. So here we have a block diagram and I need to reduce this block diagram. So let us see what can be done. A few things to be observed. So here we have a summer where these two are added. And here also there is a summer with a plus and a minus sign. So here I have a feedback path with the feedback being equal to 1 here. In order to simplify this, what has to be done? Let us move this takeoff point before a block. Now if I move this takeoff point before a block, so here I get some value, if I call this as x, into g2, right? So if I move the takeoff point before g2, I will not get g2. So therefore, I need to multiply g2 with g5, right? So therefore, what I'll do is I need to move the takeoff point. So if I move the takeoff point here before the block, I multiply g2 with g5. So this value gets simplified as g2 into g5 because the two blocks are being multiplied. So I have g2 into g5. So this is the next step. Now if you observe, I have g4 in the upper part. Now these two can be multiplied, so I get g2 into g3. So these two can be multiplied, so we get g2 into g3. So g2 into g3 is added with g4 because these two are parallel parts which are being added here. So this gets simplified as g2 into g3 plus g4. Now if you observe, again what do I have? I have this path and this path. So these two paths are in parallel. Add and subtract. So what do I get? I get g2, g3 plus g4 minus g2 into g5. Very simple. So we just subtract the value. So if I remove this, so that's going to be your next step. So I need to subtract minus g2, g5. And this multiplied with g1. So this whole thing gets multiplied with g1. So now I get g1 into, so it would be g1 into this entire term. Alright, so I have g1 into g2, g3 plus g4 minus g2, g5. So this is the expression what we have. Now then I have a feedback path where h of s is equal to 1. So we know that g of s by r of s equals g of s divided by 1 plus g of s h of s if the feedback path here is negative. So therefore, if we assume that this is g of s and h of s is equal to 1, I need to use this expression. So the final simplified expression would be g of s, which is g1 into g2, g3 plus g4 minus g2, g5 divided by 1 plus g of s is this expression g1 into g2, g3 plus g4 minus g2, g5 into h of s is 1. So this is the final block diagram what we have. This simplified, so I have r of s and this is c of s. Or we can write it as, or we have c of s by r of s is equal to this expression. So simple, isn't it? So we have solved one example, and in the next two or three video lectures we shall solve some more problems and try to reduce the block diagram so that we get the reduced expression. So do make sure that you watch all those videos and practice problems regularly. Do not forget to like, share and subscribe and press the bell icon to get notifications of all the further uploads, and thanks for watching.